All right, John Cole with growingyourgreens.com, and today I was actually eating lunch out of my garden, observing and grazing on all my food. Thought I'd make a video today about what worked and what didn't work in my garden. So, you know, not everything I'm doing here is always successful. I'm also, you know, definitely no expert in gardening, and I'm learning as I go. So I'm going to share some things with you that I've learned so far this season with growing my own food and growing your greens. What worked? Okay, so let's see. One of the things that worked was this front bed. So this front bed, you know, was a mixed bed. So we did, you know, one thing per square, and we just did just different kinds of plants. And, you know, I think it came out really cool. Looks really good. I mean, we have things from, I know, a perpetual spinach chard to Malabar spinach to strawberry spinach to purslane. We have golden purslane over there, and we have, you know, a broccoli cauliflower thing here, a couple tomatoes, Inca berries or poha berries. We have a, over here we have a eggplant, Japanese eggplant there, a couple different basils. We've got a basil there. You know, the Indian basil, that was actually quite a really good one. Actually, that's the one right here, Indian basil. In the back, we have some, drew some artichokes planted out, and some sunflowers here actually starting up. My friend Christian gave me. They're quite beautiful. So yeah, the mixed bed, I think that was definitely a success. It worked really well, and it looks really nice. I mean, I agree, in nature, a lot of things would, you know, be mixed. They would be mixed in amongst one another. They wouldn't be like this next bed, which is a monoculture, just all melons, you know, in one bed. But, you know, that seems to be working out pretty good. We got some, you know, melons coming on right there. And the next bed, that's the lettuce bed. Or right now it's also growing bok choy and Apollo Napa cabbage. I don't know if I'd do this again. It's not a good idea to do one whole bed of lettuce. I'll show you the thing that worked really well, even with the hoops. If we had the shade cloth on it, it would work pretty good. But then, you know, maybe I got to get some better shade cloth that lets some more sun rays come in. Because what happens is the lettuce seems to get really leggy, and on hot days, this is what happens. They kind of wilt. So let me show you the better alternative to doing it, you know, one whole bed with just, you know, greens and lettuce. We'll come back here to my last bed, which was, you know, my experimental bed. And actually, you know, this worked out really well. I planted this one out myself, and it's a experimental bed. So we have this, you know, tree collards that grow up tall. And the tree collards, since they grow tall, they get a lot of the sun, and they love the sun. They do really well, and they'll produce leaves all year long. We'll not go to seed. I did another episode on those. But what it does do is actually provide shade. Since these are so tall, it provides shade for everything below it. So you can see the same lettuce that we have in the front bed over there, in this bed here, it did not get leggy, and you know it's doing fine because it has partial shade due to the tree kale up top. You know, we also planted some walking stick kale and some other things that are providing shade on the sides, and that's doing really well too. So I really like this bed a lot. I mean, it is my baby. I planted it all out originally, so that was really cool. So that worked. Let's see, another thing that worked. Let's go ahead. So the cucumbers. I was thinking the other day that this might not have worked because we weren't getting a whole lot of cucumbers. But now if you come over here, I mean, I have so many cucumbers, I can't quite eat them all. I'm eating an Armenian cucumber today for lunch with my peaches. But yeah, now we have a lot of cucumbers. So I think overall this worked. I was thinking the plant spacing of, you know, planting each plant 6 inches was a little bit tight, and maybe it wasn't producing enough cucumbers because we planted them too tight, but I think it worked. What didn't work was maybe, you know, not paying attention to the radishes and letting them come up and grow too big. Maybe that didn't quite work, but it kind of did, because, you know, we got some awesome radish flowers now, and I learned anew, you know, you could eat the radish greens, and actually the radish stems are more good, more delicious. And we planted the carrots, and the carrots did work. You know, I popped up a carrot, and they're definitely good companion plants for cucumbers. So that worked. One of the other things I really want to cover really quick here was up in the front, and it's something that actually kind of worked or didn't work. So the front here, we have this mass of greens, you know, next to the arbor. And what didn't work too well was this celery. So we planted this celery, and it's pretty much in full sun, and you could see these plants look pretty stunted. They're not getting any stalks. They got a lot of greens. But if we go over here where we planted the same celery, you know, underneath some fajoa trees, and actually I think the ones in the front bed were planted first, these ones actually look like real celery stalks you'd buy in the store. So definitely don't plant celery in full sun here. So that celery worked. The other celery did not work. And so the next thing that worked actually pretty much was the lettuce. The lettuce under the fig tree pretty much worked, but you know, I'm becoming less and less of a fan of lettuce, especially growing it in the summertime. So things that worked and didn't work. Oh, the tomatoes definitely worked. Maybe next time we'd make the cages a little bit larger, but as you can see here, they're, you know, over 10 feet tall now, and that's really nice. All right, so John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com, and remember, you can grow your own greens.